Happy morning, children. Welcome to Blue Stars High Secondary School online classes. Today we are going to see the supplementary part of Unit 3 for Class 9 in English. Okay, so are you all ready with your book? Yes. So what is the name of the supplementary? Earthquake. The author is Mahadevan. Okay, so this is something about the earthquake. Okay, so I think, have you heard about the earthquakes? Yes, we should have seen in the news, okay, and papers, isn't it? So we have heard about the news, the earthquake in the news. How do you feel on reading those news or on seeing the vision of the earthquake? Okay, we feel very bad, isn't it? So what you will see, all the buildings will be completely destroyed, and it will be very bad situation. It's too clumsy to look at, isn't it? And a lot of lives will be at danger, and all the things we have, everything we have to just start our life from beginning. It will be in such a state, isn't it? So this lesson, earthquake, is also something about how a boy has lost everything, but in spite of that, he has regained his courage to live after the earthquake. How he has survived, okay, even after losing his family. The lesson is about that, okay. So you can just see the glossary part. See here, debris. What is debris? Debris is the scattered pieces of rubbish or remains. The small pieces which has just broken, isn't it? It's just debris. The remaining pieces. Devastation. Devastation is the state of being decayed or destroyed. Completely destroyed is devastation. Haphazardly. Haphazardly is in a random manner. Okay, not in a proper way. Pyres. Pyres is a heap of burnable material. Okay, they used to, burn the corpse, for burning the corpse. They will use this pyres at the funeral ceremony. Rickety. Rickety is a structure or piece of equipment poorly made and likely to collapse. Okay, which is not a strong one. Understood? Tremor. Tremor is a slight earthquake. White shrouded. White shrouded is a wrap or dress. Normally they will just cover the dead bodies with the white cloth, isn't it? So that is a white shrouded, okay, covered in white dress. Boulder is a large rock. Okay, epicenter means the point on the earth's surface vertically above the focus of an earthquake. So which is the place, the center of the earthquake, we used to say, isn't it? That is the epicenter. Makeshift is a usually crude and temporary substitute. What does the substitute make? An alternate, that is a makeshift. Okay. Petromax lamp. You know this Petromax. A type of vaporized paraffin pressure lamp. Okay. Petromax light, you know. That is the glossary part. Okay. Now, we have the introduction about this earthquake. So, earthquake is a story written by M.S. Mahadevan. This story is about a boy called Bridge. Okay, what is the boy's name? Bridge. He tells his story to a traveler. His village faced a terrific earthquake. Okay. Rescuers found all the corpses belongs to his family except his little sister. Finally, an army officer helped him to find his little sister. Okay, so what is this? It's about the after effect of the earthquake. Okay, this boy called Bridge, he has lost his family members in the earthquake. Okay, so he thought that all the family members have been died in the earthquake, but finally a rescuer, an army officer, is helped him to find the little sister, and the little sister was surviving after the earthquake. Okay, how he and the sister was surviving and how he has developed, all this is a story. And this story starts in this way. It's like he's telling his story to an unknown traveler. Okay, so see here, So this boy called Bridge, he is running a tea shop. Understood? And this boy is saying this story to a unknown traveler who is just passing by. He is just calling the traveler to his shop to have a cup of tea. And he says that is the best tea you could have in the Garhwal. Okay, Garhwal is a place. So he belongs to some other place. Okay, he belongs to a different city which was completely destroyed by the earthquake. And now he is in Garhwal and is running a tea shop. And the student is just asking this man to come and have a cup of tea. So he is just telling his life history to this man. It is in this way. The author is narrating the life history. Okay. See, greetings, traveler. You look tired and cold. Are you a stranger to these parts, waiting for the bus to Badrinath? Perhaps you are a pilgrim or a visitor to the Valley of Flowers. Anyway, whoever you are, come with me. Wait at my tea shop. It's just past the bend in the road. As you can see, I'm carrying this can of milk to the shop. In 10 minutes, I will have a fire going. While you warm yourself, I'll prepare for you the best cup of tea in all Garhwal. It will chase away the pinched blue look from your face. Here we are. Welcome to my humble roadside tea shop. Make yourself comfortable on this wooden bench. It looks rickety, but it will hold your weight. So what is he telling? He is just inviting the people who are waiting there at the bus stop. Okay, he says all the strangers will be there. Nobody will be a familiar person because he is just inviting them to have a cup of tea at the tea shop. Okay. See, he is just posing so many questions. Are you a stranger to these parts? Okay, are you waiting for the bus to Badrinath? I think you have come here on a pilgrimage. What is pilgrimage? A holy journey, isn't it? Or a visitor to the Valley of Flowers. Or else you have just come here to visit the, to see the flowers. So whomever you are, for what you have come, I don't care about it. But I'll be happy if you come and have a cup of tea at my shop, which is at the bend on the roadside. Okay, see, and he is also carrying milk in his hand. He says, within 10 minutes, I will have the fire going so that you can just sit there. By the time when you are just warming yourself in the fire, I will make you the tea. Okay, and that will be the best cup of tea in all Garhwal. In the whole city, this will be the best cup of tea. And then once you have my cup of tea, you can just chase away the cold which is surrounding you. Okay, because it is very cold, isn't it? This hot cup of tea will help you to get rid of the cold. And here we are. Welcome to my humble roadside tea shop. And he says, and he's just calling this, the strangers to the tea shop, isn't it? So he's just bringing them along with him as he's carrying the milk can in his hand. He's just calling all the strangers to the tea shop and is telling, please wait on the wooden bench. You could see the wooden bench here. And he says, though it seems rickety. What is rickety? The one which seems very damaged, isn't it? He says, though it seems very rickety, very damaged, it can hold your weight. Okay, so you can just, without fear, you can sit on the wooden bench. My name, sir, I'm called Bridge. I'm 17 years old. I started this tea shop 2 years ago. Before that, I worked in a roadside shop outside Panipat. The heat, the crowd, the pollution, it was all too much. I had saved most of my earnings. I came back and with a little help, I started this shop. By the grace of God, it provides me a decent enough livelihood. Here, your tea is ready, strong, sweet, flavored with cardamom. Enjoy it, sir, while I get on with my chores. This is my daily routine. At sunset, I will shut my shop and walk back to 3 miles to my dwelling on the hillside. The name of my village? It was my village, the village of my ancestors. It is no more. Multi is gone. Okay? So now this boy, okay, and they have not given the questions which is asked by the strangers. It is like he is just again asking the questions to them, okay, just confirming the question to them. It is just a one way of communication, okay. So he's asking, my name, sir. So what is his name? Bridge. Okay, how old is he? 17 years old. So Bridge has started this tea shop 2 years before. So before 2 years, he was working in a roadside shop, okay, outside Panipat. So that was very much hot place. Panipat is a very hot place, and there will be too much of crowd, too much of pollution. So he didn't like to be there, and so that he has saved his earnings. So whatever he has earned, he was saving it, and he is just coming back to here, and with the help of some people and the grace of God, he is starting the tea shop and he is running a good life. Okay, and now he is telling, so here your tea is ready. So how was the tea? Very strong, sweet, and flavored with cardamom. And he is telling, enjoy it, sir, while I get on with my chores. He is telling, enjoy your tea, sir. So I have little work to do in my shop. So this is my daily routine. At sunset, I will shut my shop and walk back the 3 miles to my dwelling on the hillside. So where is his house? Dwelling is the house. Okay. So where he dwelt, 3 miles away from the tea shop. Okay, on the hillside he has to walk 3 miles. So he is asking the name of my village. So the stranger would have asked, where are you coming from? What is the name of your village? So he is telling, my village. It is my village. This is the village of my ancestors, my grandfather, my great grandfather. Everybody lived there, but now it is no more. Multi. Multi is the name of the village. Multi is gone. Why it is gone? It was destroyed in the earthquake. Okay. So it was my village, the village of my ancestors. It is no more. Multi is gone. What happened to my village? So is the stranger maybe asking, what happened? So he's just again confirming the question. Okay. What happened to my village? It was 4 years ago in the month of October. One night the earth quaked. Yes, tremors are common in these parts. These snow may be seem eternal, the Himalayas may look solid, but the truth is deep down they are unstable. We who live here are accustomed to tremors. What is tremors? Tremors are the mild earthquakes, isn't it, that we have seen already. So he is telling, 4 years ago in the month of October, we had an earthquake. Okay, normally earthquakes are very common in these areas. Okay, and you can see that you are enjoying the snow here. You are very much attracted by the snow which has covered the mountain here. And also the Himalayas is looking very strong. But how was it? Inside it was very stable. It was not stable. Deep down it was very unstable. The basement is very weak. What does it mean? Often the areas are affected with earthquake. Okay. And we are accustomed to means used to tremors. We are always used to the earthquakes. Okay. But what happened that night was more than that. It was a terrible earthquake. Its effects were felt as far away as Delhi and Lucknow. So what is he telling? We are used to slight earthquakes, but that night the earthquake was very strong, very terrible, very severe. Okay, even the effect of this earthquake was felt by the people of Delhi and Lucknow. So much strong it was. Can you imagine the devastation at the heart of the earthquake? So just see, if the earthquake near the Himalayas, this can be felt at Delhi and Lucknow. How the heart of the earthquake, the place will be very much, it's very difficult to survive, isn't it? The epicenter was in a valley not far from here. So what was the epicenter? It was a valley. That is the central point of the earthquake. There were 670 villages in the valley. How many villages are there? 670 villages. Okay, so there were 670 villages were there in the valley. So who is telling the story? Yes. So I mean this boy Bridge is telling this to the stranger, the traveler. Okay, he says that there were almost 670 villages in the valley. So how many has destroyed? See, 602 were destroyed. Okay, so it was a very terrible earthquake, so that 602 villages were completely destroyed. The earthquake lasted less than 5 minutes. Just in 5 minutes, it has made such a huge devastation. Time enough to set these centuries old mountains crashing, to reduce our villages to rubble, to snuff out hundreds of life. Just in this 5 minutes, completely the villages are crashed down, and the lives of many peoples have taken away. Okay, so this is enough. This 5 minutes was more than enough for this complete destruction, he was telling. So what is the total number of villages were there? 670. Okay, how many were destroyed? 602. Okay, so it was sheer chance that I was away that night. I had gone to Pori to buy my school books. I stayed the night at my uncle's house. We felt the tremors. We ran out into the open. Again and again the tremors came. We spent the entire night outside. Pori lived through the night. Moulti did not. So what is he telling? Yeah, by chance I had just come to my uncle's house. For what? To get the school books, to buy the school books. Okay, so his uncle's house is in Pori, a place called Pori. Okay, the village. So that night he was just stayed in the uncle's house, and they could also feel the earthquake. Okay, but the earthquake which happened in this valley, the family in the Pori, the uncle's family, they could feel the earthquake. So immediately, what normally they will say, once you just feel the earthquake, you have to come out, have to run out to a open space, isn't it? So just like that, they also ran out to a open space. But this earthquake was appearing again and again. It was happening again and again. Okay, so the entire night they were spending only in the roadside, the outside. So Pori, after the earthquake, the village Pori was alive. Okay, but Moulti, what happened to Moulti? It was completely destroyed. Okay, for the living, the nightmare began at daybreak. When the news trickled in of the large-scale devastation, there were dozens of landslides, huge boulders thrown hazardously across more troubled tracks and roads. Precious time was spent in blasting the rocks and clearing the way for army rescue teams. It was all 4 days before help arrived for Moulti. So what is this? Yeah, so it was a nightmare, because normally they used to feel this earthquake, slight earthquakes. But this time, this boy thought it might be like that only. Though he is in Pori, the whole family of this boy is staying in Moulti, isn't it? Yeah, and now this boy has come to his uncle's house for getting the school book. However, even they also felt the earthquake. But they thought that it might be the normal earthquake. But what happens? The earthquake was very much high in intensity, and many landslides were taking place. Okay, and even huge boulders, they were also just, huge boulders were involved to move all the roads, the blocks, everything. They have to use these boulders to move this. Okay, and they were just making way for the army rescue team, because once the rescue team comes in, only they can make the arrangement, the rescue part. They can save the lives, or they can just dispose all the unwanted things. So they want the rescue team to come inside. For that, they are clearing up the way, okay, of the Moulti. Yes. So it was all of 4 days before help arrived for Moulti. So after 4 days, the people could come inside Moulti for rescue. I was among the first to reach the village. My uncle accompanied me. We feared the worst but nothing had prepared us for what we saw. Every single house, every wall, every roof had been flattened. Stone, rubble, and dust were all that remained. So they know because of the earthquake, something would have happened. Okay, all the buildings would have been, and something would have happened, they know. But what they saw was even more worse than that. Okay, so this boy and the uncle were the first to reach the village because their family was there. So they want to see what has happened there. What has happened? Each and every house has been destroyed. No walls, no roof, nothing. All they could see is only stones and dust. Okay, so no houses stand by there. Our house, a two-storied stone building with a slate roof. So what is two-storied? Two floors. Okay, two-floor stone building it is. With a slate roof means the flat roof. My great-grandfather had built the house. We were a small family. My father had died after an illness just 14 months ago. My mother took care of us. We were three children. I was the oldest. My brother Neelu was 10. Bhuli, my two-year-old sister, was the baby of the family. My grandmother lived with us. So who were there in Bridge family? Bridge is there and Bridge mother is there and his younger brother Neelu and younger sister, 2 years old sister Bhuli and grandmother, because the father had died only 14 months before. And they lived in this ancestral house because this was built by the great grandfather. What is great grandfather? Grandfather's father is great grandfather. Okay. So he just lived with his family in the building. When the soldiers began to clear the debris, my uncle led me away. I was in a complete daze, too numb to feel anything. The soldiers had set up a makeshift camp. Someone gave me tea and biscuits. I don't know how long I was there. Suddenly it was evening and uncle was standing beside me. "They have taken the bodies to the river bank," he said gently. "Come, you must perform the last rites before sunset. Tomorrow we will go back to Pori." So what he says? Yes. So there he was seeing very bad situation wherein all the houses have been completely destroyed and only the remains of the dust was there. Okay. And the soldiers have come there for the rescue operation. When they were just clearing this, the uncle was telling this boy to move away. Why? Because the boy might get very afraid. Okay, so the uncle is telling the boy to move away. So the boy was feeling completely numb. He could not feel anything. Okay, the soldiers had made a makeshift camp. What is it? They want to clear some other place. So they are just in a moving. Okay, so someone was giving this boy a cup of tea and some biscuits. The boy does not know how long he was there because he was all in a shock of seeing the family completely collapsed. Okay, and so soon it becomes evening and the uncle has come there to call this boy. What the uncle is telling? "They have taken all the dead bodies to the river bank for the ceremony. So you have to come and perform the ceremony. You have to come and do the ceremony before sunset." And the uncle is telling, "Tomorrow you will go back to Pori. Okay, we don't want to be here because our family is completely gone. So we can go back to Pori," the uncle is telling them. Okay, so yes. So what happens? The earthquake has completely destroyed the life of the bridge people, the bridge house people. Okay, so no one was alive. So everyone was taken to the dead bodies of all the people were taken to the river bank for performing the ceremony. Understood here? Okay, children, we stop the lesson here. Okay, so we have some more lesson which we see in the next class. So till this, you just read the lesson till this. Okay, what we have seen so far, what are the pages taught today, just see here. And I've just given some of the content from some of the things in the PDF. Copy that into your classwork. Okay, I hope you understand till now. We have stopped here, wherein the boy is getting ready for the funerals. Okay, yes, I hope you understand this. So thank you, children. Have a blessed day.